Hello everyone, welcome to Out of Spec Guide. I'm Max and I'm here in the suburbs of Almaty, Kazakhstan with a very special vehicle that I think represents a much broader trend we're seeing around the world that I thought I'd share with you today. So this is the Zeekr 1. It is the first model that Zeekr has come out with. And for those of you who aren't familiar with them because they're not sold in the US, Zeekr is a brand owned by Geely. Geely being the same Chinese group that owns Volvo, they own Polestar, which we're familiar with. They also own several other brands in China. So they become a big automotive manufacturer in the last like 15 years. But in the last few years in Kazakhstan, for various reasons, EVs and specifically Chinese EVs like this one have become very popular. And I think it's indicative of a trend of just how ubiquitous these are going to become, because this thing, which came out a few years ago, it's been updated a bit since then, has a lot of technology, is really well spec'd for the price, and I think gives, vehicles like in the US, we have heavyweights like the Tesla Model Y. This gives those a run for their money with quality and technology in the interior. So it's really cold outside, so I'm going to get inside of it and get some more footage and then tell you all about it. Hey everyone, it's Editor Max from the future with a few notes here. So keep in mind, I filmed this video while I was on vacation with family, having dinner with them. So super casually filmed, very quick. My mom's cousin, Yerlan, really nice guy, doesn't speak English. So I translated the Russian responses he had into subtitles, and he was really nice to give me access to the Zeekr 01. Another thing, for those of you who are curious, I mentioned this in the video, Zeekr 01 is not sold in the US, of course, but we do have a version of it called the Polestar 4, because Zeekr is a company that's owned by Geely, and Geely is the same Chinese automotive group or just general company. They started out actually making refrigerators, but they own a bunch of brands like Volvo and Polestar in addition to Zeekr. And so even though they don't sell Zeekr in the US, the Zeekr 1 is developed on the SEA platform, sustainable electric architecture, as is the Polestar 4. So they're not identical vehicles. The Polestar 4 has a few other tricks up its sleeve, like lacking a traditional rear windshield and instead having a camera-based one. But similar enough that if you're interested, then you can check that one out. However, it does sell for more in the US. One more note also about the Kazakh EV market that's super interesting. The reason that people like my mom's cousin Yerlan and so many folks in Almaty are buying Zeekr 1s has a lot to do with some interesting geopolitics here. So if you're interested, well, the Russian war that broke out 2 years ago impacted the Kazakh market a lot for cars in general, because previously, before that, they had been getting imports, Kazakhstan had, from Russia for the European and Japanese automakers. And that stopped, and that caused much more expensive, much more delayed imports for, like, let's say, a Mercedes or a Toyota or a Lexus, right, to get into the Kazakh market. As a result, Chinese companies swooped in, like Zeekr, and they had a particular advantage because not only does China border Kazakhstan, but also the Kazakh government exempts electric cars from import tariffs, which is a huge plus and makes them much more affordable for folks in the market for a new car, which they otherwise would have to import, pay stiff duties on, and potentially wait months for. So this has made these, particularly these Zeekr 1s, super popular in Kazakhstan. Anyhow, on with the rest of the video. Please enjoy.
Зачем вы выбрали этого, ну, именно этого машина?
Ну, во-первых, потому что это современная машина, новые технологии, и всегда хотелось попробовать не бензиновую, а электрическую машину. И выбор пал на Zeekr 001, потому что меня устраивает в нем практически все. Это динамика, это качество сборки, скорость, мягкость хода, классное управление и... Ну, большие размеры, он широкий, удобный. Ну и очень много плюсов из-за того, что не платишь за бензин, не платишь налоги.
Да.
Ну, в нашей стране налог на электромобили отсутствует.
The first thing I think super interesting is that, so if you watch this channel, you may be familiar with Tesla door handles, which, you know, on the cheaper models are the switch out style, and on the Model S and the Model X are these aerodynamic ones that have motors that flush them out. Well, here on the Zeekr 1, this is not like a, you know, super expensive Rolls-Royce vehicle or anything like that.
It's a little bit more expensive than a Model Y or like a Mustang Mach-E, but they have a really cool luxurious feature where the doors will just soft open and soft close with actuators. So you just press this button and the door opens itself, just presents itself to you like that. That is really a cool feature. To close it, it's just like that. And yeah, also you can just see from that peak there, the materials inside are all really nice, at least on first glance. So let's take a look at that. So my first impression of sitting inside of it is that it's really nice in here, well appointed. It's definitely less of a minimalist interior than like Tesla or Polestar go for, or also Geely, group member of Volvo. This is like really, you know, they're trying to kind of just impress you with the design. And the materials, at least at first glance here, are really, you know, they're not cheap. There's lots of use of Napa leather here. These front seats are ventilated, they're heated. You've got a premium Yamaha stereo system. That's interesting. In the US, we don't really see them used in car branding, but here you have a Yamaha sound system. It seems to work pretty well. But yeah, you also have lots of multicolored ambient lighting. So then they kind of beat Tesla to the punch on there. This came out well before the Model 3 refresh. You've got three screens. I believe you have this big, like 15 inch one, you've got an 8 inch one in front of the driver, and then you've got a rear display, which also you may be familiar with in some other newer vehicles. But yeah, that lets you control all the climate controls for the rear passengers. It actually seems to be quite spacious in there. But the first thing that I'm just, you know, really impressed by is the software in this. So this is running a very modern processor. The software is all actually homegrown. It's out of China. So it has nothing to do with the Android system that we see in like Polestar and Volvo EVs. It's its own thing. And obviously all the controls here are in Russian, but basically these are like drive modes you can switch between. You can control the one pedal settings. There's all kinds of configuration options here. As I'm panning around, the visualizations here are really cool. They like, this is super responsive in real time. There is a special car wash mode you can put it into, which is so convenient. It of course will fold things in and turn off your parking sensors for, you know, when you're running it through a car wash. You've got, you can actually remotely open and close the doors on here, and you can open the charge port as well. So just a really nice kind of visual interface. And this alone is just so much, you know, obviously it's very much reminds me of like what some premium vehicles in the US like the Hummer EV do with Unreal Engine, but here are Chinese EVs doing it. And this is a very, very popular one. They sell many, many more of these than they do the Hummer EV. So this is really cool. I mean, it's a little more, again, less minimalist than like what Tesla's doing. I think just a lot cooler looking. You've got like a relaxation mode and stuff. You've got notes you can do, the air suspension you can configure. So all of this is just, you know, it's packed with tech. There's even, of course, fake engine noises that you can make for people who may like that. I think, you know, I'm not a super big fan of that, but it's got everything that you could want to configure, very much being like the computer on wheels that we see with a lot of EVs. This is kind of delivering on the promise of that. As I'm closing the doors in the rear, I'm noticing the glass is double paned. So you've got some nice thick laminated glass, which should really help with road noise. And of course, frameless windows, which, you know, some people like, some people don't. It's definitely a premium feature. You've also got a panoramic sunroof like we see in many EVs. Here, unlike the Teslas, there's no like structural support in the middle. It's more like the way Polestar does it, in the existing Polestar 2 model and the Polestar 4. You just get like a pretty wide wide roof. Of course, it doesn't extend into the rear, but you do, unlike the Polestar 4, have a rear window in the Zeekr 1. Here, by the way, are your screen controls for your heated seats and everything, your USB-C and USB-A port. And then you have nice capacitive controls for things like dome lights, your window switches here as I like play with those. They actually feel really nice. They don't feel like cheap or plasticky at all. This is really nice. You've got power seat controls right there. So as the rear passenger, I want more leg room. Okay, I can move the front passenger forward. I'm not sure if that's like a weight sensor or something, if the rear passengers can adjust that while there's a front passenger in there. Definitely could see kids messing with that, but that's something you can do. So that's really cool. You can just control the incline and position of that seat to give yourself more leg room. And then, yeah, you can see, of course, there's a full internet browser there. So if you want to watch YouTube, you want to play music videos, you want to do whatever, of course, you can, just like on Tesla. We've got the customized here red interior lighting. You can even have the lighting change and react to music. So you can definitely have some fun with it in terms of the technology they're giving you. Then you've also got this pretty nice center console. You've got a little bit of space there. You could put documents and things. Now, they do market the Zeekr 1 as a touring, like, saloon, and it is essentially a station wagon. The Polestar 4, the branding more is a crossover. It's also based off this platform. But this is, I love this, you know, a proper, really just an unashamed wagon. Of course, it's got air suspension and you can raise it, but this kind of thing that we don't really get in the States. We're not even getting that new Volkswagen ID.7. So it's nice to have a proper wagon. You still got tons of space because, of course, we folded down these seats here, and you can control the air suspension settings there. But yeah, you've got a lot of trunk space overall, just way smarter packaging than like my own Polestar 2, which is derived from a gas platform. And so it has much less space. Here you actually have a lot more. And of course you have a power liftgate and everything, but yeah, overall just very premium details, lots of practical storage space. You also have quite large wheels here, and Yerlan has just opened the rear charge port. So here they use, I believe it's basically a successor to CHAdeMO. That's the Asian standard for fast charging. But in European markets, that's the CCS port. That's where you plug in for fast charging. Interestingly, for slow, like at home AC charging, they put the charge port in the front of the vehicle. So you can see similar charge port, but it's there. That's actually a very smart idea, because when you pull in normally in your garage, it's much closer, but it doesn't compromise the position of the port being where the fuel door is, right in a traditional gas car, also conveniently enough, the same place where Tesla puts it. So I think that's actually the best of both worlds. Yes, it does mean you have to have twice as many parts, but that's actually a really smart design. I'm surprised I haven't seen that in any European or US cars. So that's a look at the Zeekr 1, not so much a review of it, because of course it's not sold in the US market, but just me introducing it hopefully to many of you who are in the US or Canada or North American market, just to kind of wake you up to what is going on outside of our shores. It's really interesting. Thanks again to my relative Yerlan for showing me his and his experience with it. These have just, you know, been so popular here. He's really enjoying it. Of course, having a home charging setup really helps. He hasn't used fast charging yet because there's really no need to, but it does have pretty decent fast charging from the specs I read on the website. EV specs, by the way, this is not out of spec reviews, but for those of you who are curious, this is very similar to the Polestar 4 that's about to be sold here. Comes in a single motor rear wheel drive and a dual motor all wheel drive one configuration. So this one here is the dual motor all wheel drive with air suspension. I think it's making like 530 horsepower, 0 to 60 in like 3.5 seconds. So fairly standard EV specs, nothing to sneeze at, but definitely it puts like, you know, Mach-E GT to shame in the US, or that Chevy Blazer once they start selling it again. My gosh, American auto companies have to wake up, because once the, you know, companies like Zeekr can figure out a way to sell in the US, well, I don't know, might be trouble. I guess they already do in the form of Polestar, but the Polestar 4 is a bit more expensive. And the Polestar brand in general, I think, is kind of muddled. And I say this as a Polestar owner, not to get too rambly here, but just, you know, Geely in the US has Volvo and Polestar as Western brands. Zeekr is a very new brand. It's only existed for 3 years. Aside from this, they only have two other models. They have the Zeekr 9, which is a minivan, and the Zeekr X, which is coming out still, and that will be a cheap crossover SUV. But this right here, the Zeekr 1, is just a tour de force of technology, of like driving dynamics. You can look online. There's plenty of reviews of people who have driven them, of professional auto journalists as well, on their thoughts. But my thoughts here with one, by the way, cool illumination there. It's got all the premium features. My thoughts here, looking at Yerlan's and just seeing all of the stuff that they pack in here, is wow. For a just slightly more premium price than a Model Y, they're giving you a lot. So I totally see why in Asian markets and some European markets, this is taking over. So will the Zeekr brand come to the US? I don't know, but this is just a sign of things to come. Of course, if you watch other channels, our other channels, Out of Spec Reviews, Kyle has shown you NIO and those other brands. Here, there are plenty of other brands. There's the budget brand Chery, there's Haval, there's all kinds of Chinese EVs in Kazakhstan and, of course, other Asian markets domestically in China as well. So super interesting. And I'm really glad I could take a look at the Zeekr 1 today. So thanks for joining me and let me know what you thought of this. And whether you're going to see more coverage of foreign EVs and just the broader EV world in general, because outside the US, you know, it's not just Tesla. There's some strict competition out there that should make, Tesla really worried. That's why Elon Musk in that earnings call was saying, we got to worry about China. He's right about that. So super interesting, super fascinating. Glad I could take a look at one.